Hello, scholars. My name is Dr. Kara Stillen, and the goal of this channel is to make academic subjects easier to understand. In our last video, we covered the U.S. Constitution and put it into really easy terms. Today, we're going to take a look at the 27 amendments that have been made to the U.S. Constitution. If you remember from our last video, in order for the Federalists to gain the ratification of the U.S. Constitution by the last couple of states, the Anti-Federalists wanted amendments to be added to the U.S. Constitution. The Bill of Rights are considered the first 10 amendments to the Constitution. These were added in 1791 to ensure the rights and liberties of all citizens of the United States. Amendment 1. The First Amendment guarantees the freedom of speech, petition, assembly, press, and religion. The federal government cannot favor one religion over another or discriminate against any religion. Thomas Jefferson wrote about the necessity of a separation between church and state. The Supreme Court eventually ruled that individual rights could not present clear or present danger to anyone else. As an example, if the press wanted to be at a public trial, but it presents a danger to the accused person, the press does not have the right to be at the trial. Amendment 2. The Second Amendment states that if the government becomes hostile and has a standing army, there is a right to bear arms. The intent of this amendment is often confusing to citizens because it is questioned whether or not individuals have the right to bear arms, or do the state militias have the right to bear arms? The Supreme Court has left this up to the states to decide. Amendment 3. The Third Amendment states that citizens do not have to house soldiers in their homes during times of war or peace. The reason for this amendment originates from the British, who forced American colonists to house British soldiers in their homes before and during the Revolutionary War. Amendment 4. The Fourth Amendment makes it unacceptable for searches and seizures to take place on a person's body, within their homes, or on their property without a warrant or probable cause. A warrant has to state the place that will be searched and the persons or items to be seized. Amendment 5. The Fifth Amendment states that if an individual is arrested, taken into custody, they must be presented before a grand jury hearing to decide whether or not there is sufficient evidence to support the charge. No individual can be charged with the same crime twice. This is known as double jeopardy. In addition, an accused person does not have to testify in a trial that concerns their own guilt or innocence. Citizens can do what is called pleading the Fifth. But many individuals see this as a confession of guilt. The Fifth Amendment also discusses that no citizen can be deprived of life, liberty, or property without the due process of law. No property belonging to a citizen can be seized by the government without just compensation. Amendment 6. The Sixth Amendment guarantees that citizens have the right to a fair and speedy trial by an impartial jury of the state and district in where the crime was committed. When an individual is taken into custody, they must be informed of the nature and cause of the accusation. Today, a person must be read their Miranda rights and are told what they're being accused of. The accused individual has the right to obtain witnesses to testify in their favor. They also have the right to their own defense counsel, which means having a lawyer of their own. Amendment 7. The Seventh Amendment guarantees that individuals can have a trial by jury. In civil trials, those involving money damages, the role of the judge is to deal with questions of law. The role of the jury is to settle questions about facts. The size of the jury is not discussed in this amendment, but generally it is made up of 12 people. Amendment 8. The Eighth Amendment states that excessive bail is not acceptable for lesser accused crimes. Excessive fines cannot be imposed either. Cruel and unusual punishments are not constitutional. The court system eventually stated that dangerous persons could be held without bail even before they were convicted. Amendment 9. The Ninth Amendment stated that individual rights that are not in the Constitution belong to the people and not the government. This means that citizens have rights that may not be listed within the U.S. Constitution or within the amendments. This amendment also implied that the rights of individuals cannot be infringed upon by others claiming their own rights. Amendment 10. The 10th Amendment established that the powers of the federal government are only those that are outlined within the U.S. Constitution. Those powers that are not given to the federal government or to the state governments belong to the people. Amendment 11. Amendment 11, passed in 1798. The 11th Amendment states that federal courts cannot hear certain lawsuits against states. If individuals are suing a state, this should be held in state courts. State courts should not hear suits that are based on federal law. Amendment 12, passed in 1804. The 12th Amendment set about the Electoral College for voting in the President and Vice President. If there is not a majority vote for one person, the House of Representatives chooses the president and the Senate chooses the vice president. Amendment 13, passed in 1865. The 13th Amendment prohibits slavery and involuntary servitude. Amendment 14, passed in 1868. The 14th Amendment states that all persons born or naturalized within the U.S. are citizens. No state can make any law that takes away the privileges or immunities of citizens of the U.S., nor shall any state deprive any person of life, liberty, and property without due process. Voters must be male and be at least 21 years of age. These men cannot have been involved in a rebellion or other crime. If an individual holds a federal office, they cannot hold a state office as well. If an individual becomes part of a rebellion or commits treason, they can be removed by a two-thirds vote in Congress. If Congress has to raise money to fight against insurrections, this cannot be questioned. Federal and state governments are prohibited from financially supporting insurrections against the nation itself. Amendment 15, passed in 1870. The 15th Amendment states that the right to vote cannot be taken away from someone because of their race, color, or condition of their servitude. Amendment 16, passed in 1913. The 16th Amendment states that Congress can lay and collect taxes on incomes from whatever source derived and without regard to any census. Amendment 17, 1913. The 17th Amendment holds that the Senate shall have two senators from each state, and each term will be 6 years. If there are vacancies, there will be an election to fill those vacancies. There may be temporary appointments to replace those vacancies until an election can be held. Amendment 18. This was adopted in 1919 and repealed in 1933. The 18th Amendment prohibits the manufacture, sale, or transportation of intoxicating liquors or alcohol. This amendment was eventually repealed. Amendment 19, passed in 1920. The 19th Amendment states that no one can be prohibited from voting on the basis of sex. Essentially, this gave women the right to vote within the U.S. Amendment 20, passed in 1933. The 20th Amendment states that the President and Vice President's 4-year term will end at noon on the 20th day of January. The terms of Senators and Representatives will end at noon on the 3rd day of January. Congress must assemble at least once a year. Amendment 21, passed in 1933. The 21st Amendment repealed the 18th Amendment prohibiting the manufacture, sale, and transportation of alcohol. This amendment legalized alcohol and allowed the states to determine the rules and procedures for its manufacture, sale, and transportation. Amendment 22, passed in 1951. The 22nd Amendment prohibits a president from serving more than 2 terms of office. If something happens to the president and the vice president takes over, if that vice president who's now serving as president serves for more than 2 years, that is considered a term of office. Amendment 23, passed in 1961. The 23rd Amendment allows U.S. citizens that live in the District of Columbia the right to vote for electors of the president and vice president. Amendment 24, passed in 1964. The 24th Amendment states there cannot be any type of poll tax or other tax presented to a voter. All U.S. citizens that meet the requirements of voting have to be allowed to vote. Amendment 25, passed in 1967. The 25th Amendment sets forth a procedure to remove a President of the United States from office. If an individual that is acting as President of the United States is unable to discharge the powers and duties of that office because of illness, injury, or death, the transfer of power as well as its designation are discussed within this amendment. Amendment 26, passed in 1971. The 26th Amendment shifted the age of voting from 21 years of age to 18 years of age. Amendment 27, passed in 1992. The 27th Amendment states that no law can be made that will change the compensation of senators and representatives during their terms. Compensation for these delegates can only be changed before an election when certain terms have ended.